Welcome to the shack. I'm Rick. If this is your first time viewing, I truly appreciate you taking the time to view. I'm very thankful that you allowed me into your life even for a minute or two. A lot of people are not concerned about summer in February, but you should be preparing yourself for summer. It's going to be here sooner than you realize. That means getting your mower, your edgers, your blowers, your trimmers, all that. Change the oil, change the spark plug, sharpen the blade, general maintenance, getting ready for the summer. That way you can find any problems, issues ahead of time. My case, my mower broke down. My grass is taller than this mower. So after a lot of research, checking reviews out, even Consumer Report had the Cub Cadet highly rated. This is the very first one I've ever owned, and I have to tell you, I am exceptionally impressed. Normally, if something performs as it should, that's a 4-star. When it exceeds my expectations, then and only then is it a 5-star. I've had a few tools that way. What do you want, Moses? And I've had a few other things that have definitely exceeded my expectation. This is no exception. Unbelievable. And as you'll see, as my dog walks by, when you go through grass and weeds this tall, you know what's going to happen. Your mower's going to bog down, die maybe. If it starts bogging down, what do? You push down, lift it up, and let that grass clear out, set it back down, and do a little more. You're very, very slow getting the yard cut down. Not in this case, as you'll see. This thing completely took care of the lawn. Never slowed down, never even bogged down, and I was like, wow, that was impressive. They say it will only take 1 to 2 pulls every time. The very first startup, it took a few pulls to get things going, and as you'll hear, the idle was up and down until the fuel was in there, everything leveled out, and the idle smoothed out and was fine. So that was good. They did exactly what they said. The overall, I have to tell you, I am very, very impressed. 5 stars completely, 2 thumbs up. I did have one issue with customer service. Not with customer, but I had to call customer service. When the handle is shipped, it is folded down. There is a plate that goes on the handle, actually right there. It was sent here that was not snapped in properly, so during shipping it was bouncing around, it was all scratched up. I unpackaged this, set it all up, did a quick demo on the weekend, so Monday morning I called. No issue whatsoever. Very helpful, very concerned. Gave them my model and serial number, boom. It was in the mail that evening. It was supposed to show up today, but it's not here yet, so maybe tomorrow, or sometimes they don't like coming down the dirt road, they'll just take it to the post office. So I haven't been to my mailbox yet to see if I may have something there. Power assist, I've never owned a mower that was not completely self-propelled, but as you'll see in my demonstration, the handle is exceptionally comfortable. As you walk, your normal momentum will push the handle forward. When that handle goes forward, it engages the drive mechanism. My mother has a mower that is self-propelled, but it takes off. You better keep up with it. This, because of the gearing, I guess, I don't know how they actually do this, and that's a concern as far as longevity. Might be an issue down the road. I don't know. Maybe a lot to repair. I don't know about that, but for now, it is fantastic. So as your normal momentum as you walk will push the handle forward, that engages the drive mechanism, the mower takes off and it won't go any faster than you're walking. I can walk fast and it'll push the handle further down and the mower will start going faster. Or if I slow down and back off, the mower will slow down and keep up with me. This makes mowing the lawn enjoyable again. It's not a chore, it's actually fun. I want to go out there and mow more and more. So if you're looking into one of these, this I definitely suggest. This is the Cub Cadet This is the SC500HW. Look in the description below. I will have all the information, everything, specs, and all that will be in the description. Now, I did open this up at Home Depot. I bought it through them, and they delivered it to the store because I would rather have it there than have it delivered here in case there's something wrong. And I told them, same thing. Everybody complains about the packaging. So they opened it up. It looked fine, so we hope everything's okay. That's basically it. It's just a cardboard box. There is really nothing protecting this from damage anywhere. You should have your manual, some parts, and oil. And the oil is in this plastic little baggy thing here. Like I said, I never use a bag. I've always used the mulching part of it. I don't even use bags anymore. Like I said, that's all you got to protect the front. Protect the back. You got nothing on the sides there.
A little bit better view. See? There's nothing at all on the sides here at all. So that could be in, I don't know what it looks like underneath, on the side here, on that side, we don't know. There is no packaging. A little bit of bubble wrap on top of this, I mean, really.
I don't know where that goes to, but that's all tweaked out, whatever that is. This, I guess, actually goes on here. It's plate cover. But this is all from bouncing around. It's all tweaked out. I don't want this. So I'm going to talk to him about that. Let's get this thing out of here.
Now, let's see. It's just dust. That all comes off. No damage. It's dirty. This is your washout, single-handed operation. Push it down, ooh, a little fast. But you can do it with one hand, raise it. Oh, that's smooth, that's nice. Height adjustment, very easy. That's good.
Somehow, you gotta get this. Oh, there you go, okay. There we go. You gotta lift the back up to get that off. Bring this back around again. Actually, it all looks pretty good. There's no damage except for that one piece that came off the handle up here. And again, the back. Yeah, that's very smooth height adjustment. I have to give you that. That is a very effortless adjusting the height.
All right, let's get into the instructions. Let's get this thing, make sure it's done right, assembled properly, and we get going.
We have our instructions. We have engine oil. Looks like we have a deflector, and maybe these look like snaps for cables. Yep, for the cables on the handles. So you got a manual on the mower, manual on the engine itself. 159cc OHV vertical shaft engine. Take this off here now. So what you want to do is take these carriage bolts and the spinner off of here, both sides. Now we can flip it up. Make sure you don't bind any of these or tweak them. Keep them on the outside. You don't want to hurt them. These here, so that'll slide up and down. I just want to leave it there for now like that. Now the other thing, you take this handle, this T-bar out. Now, you can pull this out, extend it. This is good, but you can have this adjusted a little bit here. This has three settings, so you can either up or down to get this to set the way you want it. Bring it down just a hair more. Right there. Oh yeah, that's perfect right there for me. Now that that's set to where it's comfortable for me, we can tighten everything up.
Next up, to secure the pull cord, we're going to pull it out of the motor gently, because again, we don't have any oil in it yet, so we're just going to pull it up. And on the handle, we're going to secure it to the eyelet right here on the handle. Basically,
I'm just going to unscrew this, pull it out. Again, gently pull the cord up. So pull it up, and you see there's a, it's like a J, it's a little opening right there. You're going to insert that, slide it through, and it'll keep the top, the opening towards the top. I'm not going to flip it down, I'm going to put it on the top. And we're going to screw this with the dome end first. That way it sets inside this countersink on the tubing. Put that in there, screw this on, and we're good to go. Snug it up. There we go. That's how you secure the pull line onto the handle.
Now you have these little cable clips snap over the handlebar here, and it keeps these cables separated. What you want is one cable on this side, one cable on that side. You want to keep them separated. So I'm going to snap this on. There you go. See, you want to keep these cables separated.
So this is the top. That's the handle. You set it in this way. This will have to go on this way. The plastic is the bottom. You slide that in there. This one here first. Let's see if we can get this up. There it goes. There, snap over there. Get this one here. Up and over. Put your finger there. It's not the easiest to get this thing to slide over. There it goes. There, slide it over. Work on the side. Each one of these do the same thing. You have to get a little screwdriver or just use your finger and pull them open in. Oh, there's gonna be one difficult one. There it goes. Oh. There it is, your bag for the grouse. Now when you're ready to put this in, these little tabs here fit right here. They just rest right there. So take your back flap, open all the way up. You sit that in there, rest that over the tab, set it down, close it. That's it, that's simple. Now if you don't want to use the grass catcher or mulching and you want to just discharge it through the side, that's what this port's for. You lift this up, the little tabs on the other side where the spring holds this in, you'll see the little hooks up here. Those hook in right here, so you just lift it up, set it on there, let it down, set that down, and there's your side discharge diverter. It just shoots it out to the side. Fully assembled, everything fits. We are missing nothing, everything's fine, other than that one little piece that was off in shipping. I have to call the manufacturer about. Let's add the oil, put some gas, and let it start up for the first time. Now it does come with 20 ounces of 10W30 premium four cycle engine oil. What we're gonna do, take this off, open this up. There's our dipstick. Nothing as of yet. Going to just pour this directly in there, break the seal. It should take the full amount. Don't have to worry about a spout because this will sit in there and just let it drain. Now we're just going to stick this in. Now you'll see on here, it's got two holes and some hash marks. You want it to be in the operating range, which is between these two. So it's going to make sure that this is going to be the operating range. It's just about right in the middle. It's right in the middle right now. And it's almost used this all up. And it hasn't started yet, so once you start it, it will cycle in the engine. So we're not going to overfill it too much. We're going to fill it up, we'll start it, let it run, shut it off, then we'll check the oil level again and make sure it's in operating range. Cut in. It's right at the bottom of the second hole, so it's right there. So I'm going to leave it there for now. Going to get some gas put in, and we're going to give it a start. Let it run, we'll shut it off, we'll check the oil level again, make sure it's still in the operating range. I'm going to pull on it gently just to cycle the oil a little bit. And then I'm going to yank on it to try to start it, but we're good to go. Very small, gently, just pulling on it. Just to cycle the oil a little bit. Okay. All right, now we're going to see. I'm going to give it a regular full. Excellent. Once that gas thing got in there, it got stabilized, everything was good. It leveled out and it was idling right. Now, let's check the oil, then I'm going to go over something real quick with you. Perfect, it's full. It is good. Yeah, it's over the full mark, so I'm going to leave it. I don't want to overfill it. I know they may say just empty that whole bag into it, but I'm not going to do that. When you start it, you pull the handle back to start, and you can grab on both sides. I mean, it fits in this ridge perfect, so it's very comfortable. Pull it to start. This being assisted drive, when you push this handle forward to start walking, it would automatically engage the rear wheels to start moving. Now, if you push harder, go faster, you push this further and it goes faster. That's what's so unique about this. It will go at your own pace. So if you just push a little bit, it'll just engage a little bit. If you're walking faster, pushing it, pushing this handle further forward, it's going to keep up with you.
Just how extreme this little cubby is. This thing's kicking some butt. You see, my grass is extremely tall. I haven't had a mower in a couple months with this rain. This stuff is just growing, and plus I got weeds. I'm going to show you just how fast it cuts through this very tall. You're looking at a foot and a half. We're going to check it out and see how well this undercarriage washout system works. I'm going to take off the side discharge diverter here, shut that flap down, turn it around, and we're going to hook the hose up. And basically, we turn the water on, pull the handle, start it, let it run for 2 minutes, shut it off, and we're going to see. So I'll take this off. We're going to look underneath before and after. Okay, I'm going to try to lift this up best I can. Let's see, because the grass is so wet, look how much is underneath there. That thing is full of grass. This is where we connect the hose. It's like a quick disconnect feature. Pull up, comes right off. We're going to connect the hose to it. Connect it back on. Turn the hose on, let that thing circulate, then we're going to turn it on. Let's see how good this thing looks underneath. Yeah. Whoa, look at all that. Oh yeah. A little bit in there, but that's good. I can clean that out with a hose, but I'm gonna rinse this whole thing off because the grass was wet. But yeah, that is very impressive. Very, very nice.
Wow. That was absolutely effortless. If I wanted to go faster, I'd push the handle more forward and engage it more to go faster. Most of the time you saw, I put one hand and just kind of edged it a little bit to get over that thick grass and weeds. And this thing cut through, never even slowed down. The engine never even bogged. I got nothing but thumbs up, 5 stars, man. This, it definitely outperformed my expectation. There was no damage, but the packaging is a little skimpy. I definitely agree with everybody out there that reviewed this saying packaging kind of sucks. This is not available in the store. You have to order it. And that's it. It worked absolutely beautiful. It was a pleasure to mow the lawn again. So if you're dreading the green Saturdays, getting out doing all the yard work mowing, I'm telling you what, you got one of these, it's not an issue anymore. Cub Cadet, this is a thumbs up, 5 star. With that, I truly appreciate you taking the time to view. If you're looking for more this summer, getting ready, get everything prepped ready before spring, I highly recommend you look into something like this. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you taking time to view. I think maybe over here. Like, subscribe, enjoy, get out there, take back your shack, build it for a friend. Always build it for family, but most importantly, build it for your sanity. And then get out there and mow the lawn a little bit. Clear that mind. It's all about enjoying life. I gotta go. I got other things to do. See you next video.